fellas in the back, sweet singers in the front, cruising down the freeway in the hot, hot sun. Suddenly red blue lights flash us from behind, loud voice booming, please step out onto the line. Ballet bridge waves of comfort, Cena just hides her eyes, policeman taps the shades, is that a Chevy 69? How bizarre. How bizarre, how bizarre. How bizarre.
Are we?
We're recording.
Oh, yeah, we're recording.
I like it.
Nice. Great.
We're going.
I know. So, lucky last of day two. Bianca Rasho, Senior VP Talent Acquisition at GQR. Thank you very much for coming on.
Thank you, Charlotte.
How's your day been?
It's been good.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's great.
Busy?
Yeah, I'm glad to finally meet you guys. So that's been fun, having you by the office.
Yeah, it's been so great coming out and doing this trip. I think, you know, we've done a good bit of work with you guys and also some of the other clients that we've got here. And it's just fantastic to come and see the space. By far the coolest office. I think I have to give you guys credit for that.
Thank you. We try. We try. Yeah.
It's got a, I love the whole warehousey vibe thing. Mm-hmm. It's pretty awesome.
So this building does have a bit of history for any car fans. It's actually the old Carroll Shelby car factory. And
nice.
The doors that you see, they were just wheeling out the cars right on. Those are the original doors, original
nice.
Building.
That's pretty cool. And you've got some cool cars inside as well, I've seen.
We do, yeah. There's some car fans in the office. And then we also have... Next door, we have a couple talent agencies and like a video gaming company. So
wow.
Sometimes we get some like celebrity spottings in the area.
Nice. I've been trying my best to spot celebrities and I have had no such luck.
No.
I think I actually make them up. We drove past someone that vaguely looked like Khaleesi and I was like, I'm just going to tell everyone that I've seen her. I'm claiming it. But anyway, we digress. So tell us a little bit more about what your remake is for, you know, GQR. What are you responsible for?
Yeah, so I've been with GQR for about 4.5 years now, and currently heading up the talent acquisition team in the Americas. So
nice.
Focusing on just scaling up the U.S. business. That's where we're seeing an incredible amount of growth right now.
And that's across all offices?
Across all offices. So our compound annual growth rate as an organization is 41%.
Wow, nice.
That does categorize us as a hyper-growth firm. And I would say probably like 70-80% of that growth is focused here in the Americas. So
okay.
We have a lot of fun working really closely with the C-suite on what are some of the business's objectives, how can we scale the talent acquisition team to meet those objectives?
Yeah.
And then also partnering with folks like you guys to help us bring in additional talent.
Nice. And here in LA, from what Rory was saying, LA is in particular going to be going through some big growth, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. So we have 59 people in this office, but we can house 250. So we've kind of moved into this location with space to grow.
Yeah.
So obviously, with the kind of rent in Southern California, we want to make the most out of that.
For sure.
So definitely a lot of room to scale up the business here in Los Angeles, and then across the globe. So I think a lot of our employees and candidates do appreciate that there is that international mobility to their career here. And then the way our specialisms work is, you know, they are practicing in every office. So, for example, if you're an expert in, let's say, data science here in Los Angeles, you could easily go and pick up your business in another office as well.
Which is fantastic. You know, that really gives people, I suppose, that option to move with their careers, which a lot of people want to do nowadays.
Yeah.
Different experiences. So is the growth, are you seeing that across all the discipline areas, or is there a focus in any particular one or two, or how's that looking?
I mean, the opportunity is there for all of our markets. We do focus on candidate-driven, highly technical spaces for that reason. And we are quite nimble with the market. So for example, if You know, a certain industry takes a hit based on government regulations, et cetera, market conditions. We can be quite nimble in terms of going into complementary spaces that aren't necessarily affected by that. So we have strategically picked our specialisms for that reason. I'm seeing a lot of folks in healthcare here locally. We're seeing a lot in the digital transformation space as well. Really excited to grow out our energy divisions, our legal divisions, investment advisory, just to name a few. We're also growing talent acquisition as well. So anyone that is interested in, you know, maybe being able to kind of grow an organization and have that more personal impact where you see the people that you place on a daily basis, but still have the earning potential, the excitement, the sort of ambition of a fast growing agency. I think that would be really interesting.
No, definitely. I
plug,
think so too.
Plug my team here.
So. Yeah, go for it. Why not? Okay, interesting. And so I know we've spoken that about that before. You do have some strong sort of growth plans for your team in particular. And that's not just here in LA, but you're looking for sort of New York, Austin as well. Is that right?
Yeah, London, Sydney, across the globe looking to scale. So we have 6 employees right now within talent acquisition. We want to add an additional 8 to the team.
Brilliant.
We have about 5 offers out, so that's good. We've made some of those placements, but looking to make those additional 3
With
by
those
January.
Sort of growth plans that you guys have, that's going to be really integral to the business, I think, isn't it, in executing those. So
yeah, definitely.
Cool. So one thing we've noticed whilst we've been here in LA and in the sort of US in general is, you know, if we rewound a couple of years back, you know, there would be sort of a limited number of players. Mm-hmm. But now, certainly in the last few years, there's been a lot more sort of UK companies coming out, a lot more people sort of setting up. And that's kind of across America, but in particular in LA as well. So how are you guys kind of differentiating yourself in the market to, you know, your competition, essentially?
Yeah, I'm glad you asked that. You know, I think a big thing is our investment in our staff, particularly from a learning and development perspective, a growth perspective. So for us, we do have an external learning pathway where at a certain level, which is typically like a team leader level, you get a budget to kind of go out and whether it's, you know, go take some courses, do some executive coaching. Some people are looking at MBA programs and that's sponsored by GQR. So the budget there is $4,000 to $24,000, depending on an employee's rank within the business. And this idea that, you know, if you're going and taking these external courses, let's say you want to improve your managerial skills, your negotiation skills, say you work in the JavaScript market, you know, go learn some of those technical skills so that you can have better interactions with your candidates and your clients. That's been really exciting. I actually had my first executive coaching session today with a career coach, and she was incredible. Just in terms of, you know, the success that she's had. She's a female CEO and definitely someone that I can learn from. So that's kind of one of our learning and development options. Additionally, we do have very structured tailor programs for any senior hire coming into the business. And when I say senior hire, I mean anyone who has recruitment experience.
Yeah.
For folks without recruitment experience, we have a 12-week foundations program followed by, you know, continuous education. I think really it's just about the amount of resources that are here.
Yeah.
We also have a e-learning platform as well. So let's say you don't want to kind of, you know, book in a session. You want to be able to kind of learn in your own time. There's about 300 plus courses on there right now.
Nice.
I mean, that's just going to continue.
Yeah, of course.
So it's a relatively new program. Additionally, our relationships with our clients, I think, are another differentiator. We have our client services division, which the goal there is to expand out our client lifelong value. And we're able to offer our clients extended services such as people intelligence, employer branding, mm-hmm. events and experiences, whether they're looking for an RPO solution, a retainer solution, just a lot of kind of flexibility and autonomy with how you can service your clients and mm-hmm. how, you know, we can move from, you know, what could be like a transitional placement to, you know, how can we maximize this client from $500,000 in spend with us annually to $2 million.
Yeah.
And the resources that we have in place to do that, we have a completely separate client services team that would get, you know, paid out totally separate of any commissions that consultants would make to go in and further sort of penetrate those relationships.
And you guys are doing some really cool stuff in technology as well.
Yes.
It sounds like.
Yeah. So, I mean, truly disrupting the industry in terms of what our CEO Stephen Talbot's really passionate about. A lot going on. So we've recently launched our AI platform. It actually made first placement this week. I'm sure Rebecca and some other folks can talk in detail about that, but really being able to understand, you know, our database, the power that our database has, especially with high value strategic technical talent, oftentimes, you know, in C-suite executive roles, you know, how it can be kind of searching for profiles without us necessarily having to do a Boolean search or really understanding, you know, where these candidates are at if we haven't contacted them in, let's say, years, really being able to kind of regenerate that.
Which is just awesome. I think, you know, that's really kind of refreshing for the industry, because I know when Delta spoke with Rebecca, you know, recruitment, it has a little bit of a bad name in the sense of this is how we've recruited for the last 20 years and this is how we will continue to recruit. So it's really exciting that you guys are doing such different and innovative stuff. It's really refreshing. I think one of the things I noticed out there, I mentioned to Rory when I was kind of looking at your sales team as well, is it's a lot of women, like, you know, or certainly, you know.
We want more.
A larger number.
Ladies, come to GQR, please.
Well, I mean, a lot of the places we've been so far, I mean, great companies, like really, really enjoyed them, but it's very male dominated. And definitely here in the US in general, when we've sort of visited in New York, but also here. So it's nice to see that there's a focus on that diversity element as well. So are you guys really making a conscious effort to try and sort of, you know, grow your female sort of sales force and being quite diverse?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think it's not just really about the talent attraction piece, but it's about building a environment to foster people to continue their careers here, right? So, I mean, I would love to see more of it. I think we're still, you know, just around that, like, maybe 60-40, 50-50, we do a lot to kind of promote diversity of thought within the organization. I mean, we do have a lot of folks from international backgrounds, you know, across the globe, across the nation, obviously. But, you know, I think we're just scratching the surface when it comes to the D&I efforts. And excited, you know, to hear from some potential candidates that know a little bit more about this and you know, can come in and make an internal impact.
Yeah, exciting. All right, great. Well, look, it sounds like some really cool stuff. I'm so glad that we've had a chance to meet, because we've obviously been back and forth now for a long time. So it's really great. So
thank you.
Really appreciate you coming on. Thank you.
Thank you.